It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
There you go.
And this is the Wizard Product Review on this week's show.
On this week's show, we've got some really exciting brand new products that have just come out. A lot of buzz about a lot of the stuff that we've got on the show this week. And the first thing up is Michael Chatelain bringing out Hole. And the last thing we looked at Michael's, which was Ink, was amazing. We've looked at stuff in the past that we haven't been too keen on. I came into the unit.
To a card as well.
Yeah, which was very good. Rewind. Yeah. I came into the unit yesterday and Dave said, you got to see this. And you showed me Hole and completely blew me away. I had no idea how this works. I don't know if you've seen the video demo, guys, but this is an amazingly stunning fooling effect. It really is.
Shall I do it?
Can you do it?
Shall I do it now? John, yeah. Can we get it off the sticks? Blamwell's not interested at all. First of all, it uses a couple of cards. And you're going to fix these two cards together with a sticker. Now, as Mark Lavelle pointed out at the shop, you could actually have a branded sticker if you wanted to.
With your business card details.
So you've got the sticker that side and that side. So it
kind of
fixes it together like a little hinge, like that. And then you take another card.
And this can be freely selected inside.
You can select this card. You can take it out of the deck. And you really do put it between the two cards, and I'll show you that. I'm going to show you front and back, and it really is in between.
It really is.
Right there. And then you see the impossible. The card melts straight down through the sticker like that. You can immediately hand that to them. You can open up the hinge card. If you like, you can take the sticker off,
put the sticker on the card,
and give it away. If you want to as well.
Oh, yeah, this
is
really
good. I was playing around. You can actually do a sort of misled style effect if you want to, and put it in the middle like that, and it can be a misled style effect.
Which also looks very, very good. Boom.
And that can just be a spectator's signed bill.
The thing with just one important consideration, this part here cannot be examined, but the routining behind the effect means that all the heat is on whatever's passed through, the signed card, the bill, and the heat isn't on those cards. And if you really wanted to, as they're looking at that, you could switch them out, although I don't think it's necessary.
Yeah, I'm not sure about performing it at a table in a close-up environment. I'm not sure about performing it in a drinks reception situation. There's no doubt, though, that this is a very baffling effect. Mm. And if you wanted to perform it in a stage presentation, on a video screen, you know, full frame in front of your face, like, you know, Copperfield's legendary performance of Misled by Timothy Wank years ago, I think it would go very well. And I think as an interlude and illusion show on a video screen, if you do that sort of presentation, I think it's awesome for that.
I agree, but how many people are going to be in a situation where they need an interlude piece in an illusion show?
Yeah, I know.
My issue with this,
you're right,
is that it looks like a toy. It looks a little bit toy-like.
I don't agree with that.
Well, yeah, you know who? You know, I'm going to bring out a card with a hole in it, and I'm going to, you know,
I think it looks like a toy. I do disagree with you there.
I like to be slightly more organic when I do card magic, and I like to just have a pack of cards and be able to go right into it. I think that when you're bringing out a card with a hole in it, you're kind of saying to people, there's something special about this card. And although, like I said, with the routining, the heat is on the thing that passes through it, I'd need to really justify the use of a hole on a card. One idea that I had is you could use the presentation of, you could have some business cards printed up with a picture of a woman on there, and you could bring these cards out and say, have you ever seen the illusion?
So this looks like a toy, right, John? So this looks like a toy. So what you're going to do to make it better, is you're going to bring out a card with a picture of a woman on. Yeah, because that makes it look a lot more organic, doesn't it?
Okay, well, yeah, I'm
slightly flawed argument
I'm
going on right here.
I'm trying to embrace the toy-like look of it. You know, if you're going to go that route, you may as well just go there 100%. I know you disagree. I know you disagree.
Look, yeah, look, we've already said.
Right, look, bottom line.
You can put your business card through it.
Would you do this in a real world situation?
This whole argument just ended when you said it got better with a picture of a woman. You can put a bill through it. You can put a business card through it.
Would you do it?
That's a good idea. In a close-up walk-around situation, no.
And why would you not do it?
Because
it looks like a toy?
No, because the limitations of people saying, can I have a look at that? And the fact that you've got cards with holes in, that's the special part. I think people would want to look at that bit. But in a situation where you could control your environment a bit more, there's no doubt, just like the trailer, I think it looks fantastic.
No, I do. I think it looks very, very good.
How much are you going to give it?
You're going out performing, you want to do your best magic. Is that really the best thing that you can do? I think magicians sometimes, they fall into the trap of, this has completely fooled me and therefore it's going to work brilliantly for my audiences because it's fooled me. But it's not about what's fooled a magician.
Yeah.
It's about what works with real people. And I think there's effects out there.
But correct me, just before we're reviewing, we've already spent 6 minutes on this. We're trying to aim at 5 minutes of review, but this has been a little bit argumentative. I showed you this yesterday. You were like, that's fantastic.
Yes,
that's
brilliant. I did.
Give it me now.
Yes,
that's fantastic.
Yes, I also said that, yeah.
You were on your way to your lecture. I phoned you. You said, I'm still thinking about that.
Yeah. And you know why?
I wanted
to show my magic buddies.
Then you found out, and you found out about it, and you're not as impressed by it. And I don't know why. Just because you know the secret.
Well, because I don't think I'd do it. There's no point in...
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it... 69%.
That it?
Yeah, 69%.
Give it 87%. Right, lots of people have been asking us, Craig, over the years. We get lots of sort of reoccurring questions. One is, how do we rate our percentages?
Yeah, they want to know what our judging criteria is. And frankly, I get asked this question so many times. And the bottom line is, I pretty much make them up as I go. And people have pointed out to me. They've pointed out to me and they've said, but 2 years ago, you actually scored this 90%. And you said that it was better than this. And this was only 78%. Well, and they're right,
So we've got some criteria.
We've put a criteria together.
Judging criteria.
So you guys
this
know.
This is strict now.
Yeah, you know what our criteria
we've
is.
We've had meetings, haven't we, John?
Yes.
Yeah.
We had meetings.
Yeah.
We sat in the session lounge and had a coffee.
Yeah.
It got that serious.
It really did.
They were biscuits.
They were nice biscuits.
We invested in this time.
Right. So we're going to give you our judging criteria.
Right.
If a product gets between 0 and 10%.
Right. We wouldn't touch it with a barge pole.
No. Neither me or Dave would go anywhere near it. And it's 100% guaranteed to get a rant from me.
Rant guaranteed. So 10 to 20%. We wouldn't touch it with a barge pole, but Matthew probably would.
But it still has a pretty damn good chance of getting a rant
still
from me.
Still getting a rant, yeah. 20 to 30%. So you're out and a hot girl says, show us some magic.
And that's all you've got on you.
It's all you've got on you. You might touch it with a barge pole.
But only briefly.
Rant?
80% chance of a rant.
Right, 30 to 50%. Right, we don't really like it, but we appreciate that someone else may like it.
Probably wouldn't get a rant, but there's a good chance it would get an elongated moan.
We don't like it, and we'll explain the reasons. 50 to 70%. It's getting there, but still it's flawed for reasons that we will explain.
Yeah.
Rant?
Probably not a rant, but a moan, still probably a moan. Yeah.
I'll probably use it as an excuse to make me look really professional.
Yeah.
70 to 90%. This is probably not good enough to go into Craig's number one set.
What? 70 to 90%. This is probably good enough to go into
Now good enough to go into great.
Yeah. Because 70 to 90%.
Matthew did the minutes. Sorry.
Yeah. 70 to 90%. Yeah. 70 to 90%. I think it's really good. It's going into my working set.
Right.
Probably.
90 to 100%. Actually, good enough to go into Dave's number one set. Once again, an opportunity to make me look more professional. And much love from the Wizard Product Review. Maybe even a possible Worker of the Week. Definitely no rants in sight.
Not a single rant.
Congratulations to Samuel Rico, who was the winner of the Wizard Wheel competition, correctly identified that there were 22 eight balls in that tub. And we couldn't get in touch with him because we only decided today the winner, and he's in Jakarta. But this spin goes out to you
Samuel. I'm going to give this such a good spin.
No, it's my turn.
I did it pathetic.
No, you haven't done it.
Oh, come on.
It's my turn, isn't it, John?
Yeah.
I'm not normally John's here when the wheel gets spun.
John's the boss. Right, you ready?
Ready.
3, 2, 1 for a TA box set. There we go. The whole thing's falling over. Oh, he gets a Vegas road trip DVD.
Still a very good DVD.
The highest rated product of this week as well. Coming your way, Samuel.
Get in contact with us.
So next up, we've got The Inception by Chris Randall.
The man, the myth, the legend. He can pull any bird in Vegas.
And he proved it.
And he proved it, yeah, over and over again. And
you made him sound like a
Get a girl's phone number.
We don't mean that, Chris. He did it once.
He did it once.
He did it once.
He did it once, but I believe he can do it. He can do it a lot. Anyway, so what's Inception? Here you go. Inception is an anytime, anywhere...
Inception is a Bill and Lemon routine, by
anytime,
the way.
Anytime, anywhere, self-contained Bill and Lemon routine. Honed on the streets of Vegas, you get the inner workings for one of magic's most powerful pieces, as well as Chris Randall's years of experience performing this effect.
Now, when I first looked at it, I got to confess that the sort of process I went through when I looked at it, I watched the performance, mm-hmm. and I was very much focused on the actual Bill and Lemon itself.
Yeah.
And I was like, many people that watch the Wizard product review know that I'm a bit of a disciple of Doc Eason.
So am I.
And I was kind of like watching it and thinking, well, there's nothing here that Doc's not gone into.
Yeah, because Doc's DVD set... is not only the best DVD set the world has ever seen, but also has the single... It is. It just is. It's the best DVD set ever invented, and it's got the best Bill and Lemon I've ever seen. I think that...
It's very entertaining.
I do Bill and Lemon in Cabaret, and it's pretty much based on Doc's routine.
But you can't judge everything on what you've seen before.
No.
As we always say on the Wizard Product Review, you have to discuss... a product on its individual merits, as if it's come through your letterbox and this is it. And we're going to consider this if you've never seen a Bill and Lemon routine explained on DVD. If you've got Doc Eason's routines already, you might not like this. You might kind of think, well, I like Doc's method more. If you've got Scott Alexander's Final Answer.
I bought that. That cost me an absolute fortune. You can't get it anymore, but I bought it. And
were you happy with it?
I was quite disappointed because there were problems with using it with UK notes. I think it's a genius idea. I couldn't use it because being in the UK.
But part of his development was seeing Doc, seeing Steve Spill, seeing Scott Alexander.
And his crediting on the DVD is exceptional.
It's very good.
In fact, there's a section on the DVD, a bonus section, where Scott Alexander and Chris Randall sit down and have a 20-minute chat about Bill and Lemon, and it's a very, very interesting discussion. And hearing two professionals sit down and talk about it, you get a lot of really good
ideas.
And
all the tips about getting tips.
Yeah. They're going to big... and that's true. I mean, I do shop in restaurants all the time, and it's such a great way to get tips. It really is.
Right. So what we want to get across straight away, before we even start this review, and we kind of wanted to make ourselves clear, is... if you know Doc Eason's method, you know Scott Alexander's method, you've studied Steve Spill's work, indeed you've got Chop.
Yeah.
You might not be too enamoured with the actual Bill and Lemon part of the routine.
Yeah, because there's only one real way to get a signed bill into a lemon.
Which is real magic, and that's explained on this DVD. But this is so much more than just Bill and Lemon.
Oh, it really is. First of all... you get a full live performance of Chris performing this on the streets of Las Vegas, which is a fantastic, brilliant performance. But then you get a commentary track. So you can see the performance again, but you hear Chris talking over what he's doing and where he's doing it and when, which is a great teaching aid. It's absolutely fantastic.
And it's not just Bill and Lemon.
It's
not. This is a full routine.
Yeah, so he starts off with the borrowing a bill. The bill turns from a $100 bill into a $1 bill, or from a $20 bill into a $1 bill. Then he goes into a whole bunch of audience interaction. He goes into a rope routine.
Elements of Daryl's routine, elements of fiber optics.
And then he brings everything full circle at the end with the bill going into the lemon. It's a 10 to 15 minute presentation that he's done on the streets for years and years. It is a brilliant routine.
He's got
to watch.
Really cheeky bit at the end as well with the guys $20 bill.
Yeah.
And it's like all sodden with lemon juice, and he just casually thanks everybody for the show, and he just drops it in the champagne bucket.
Yeah, it's
I thought
great,
that was great.
Absolutely brilliant. Hey, if you're interested in getting into street magic, there's some brilliant DVDs out there, but if you're interested in getting into a street magic and wanting to go out and do busking, this is a fantastic DVD to watch, because you could just take Chris's performance, adapt it to yourself and go out and do that routine over and over again. But here's the thing, and I think I know you're going to say the same thing. This street performance that Chris offers will also work as a standalone 10-minute piece at a table.
Yeah, it would work at a table. I actually did a job the other day.
Yeah.
No joke. I did Bill Switch. And because it was only for 30 people.
Okay.
And I did the ring routine straight after. And I was actually watching this thinking, I wish I'd have seen that just to finish the routine off nicely. Yeah. And the Crown Royal bags that he uses, where he's got the bag and the lemons inside.
Everything's self-contained.
We checked those out on eBay. You can get 5 for £3.50.
Yeah.
I think there's a bit of shipping on that as well. And it's a really nice routine. And this is a full routine. This could easily become somebody's act.
It really could. You could make a reputation from doing this act over and over and over again. And it's great to see. The teaching, by the way, of it is brilliant.
Yeah.
It goes through the Bill Switch with and without a TT. It was great to see somebody agree with what we've been saying about all these Bill Switches.
Yeah,
he comes out and
us.
He goes, I use a $100 Bill Switch with a TT because it's the cleanest way of doing it. Because you can have people behind you. And
he sacrifices how beautiful and magic for magicians certain moves can be. For the fact that he can go like this and show his hands empty.
He teaches the rope routine. He explains everything in fantastic detail. This is a brilliant DVD. It's going to inspire you to be a better magician, I think. I think it's absolutely fantastic. You know, we've talked about some of Chris's DVDs in the past quite negatively. This is brilliant. This is genius.
This is brilliant. If you've studied Billing Lemon before...
Still get it, I say.
Yeah, I'd still say still get it, because there's some nice ways that make the loading very simple and very straightforward. It's obvious he's worked it. It's a worker.
It's a worker. It's got to get Worker of the Week, because that's the thing. If you work, if you learn this, you've got a working routine that you're
going
to use forever.
Is it going into your number one set?
It's definitely going into my number one
I think it's going to go into my number one set.
You know what? I'm going to give this 95%. I think it's brilliant. I really do.
I'm going to give it 93%. John, Worker Special?
Yeah, I think it deserves it.
Worker Special. Toss
it
over.
Good idea.
Right.
So we got here Dave and Craig, the Vegas Road Trip.
Starring,
and I think that's why he's done it, amongst other people. You've got Chris Randall on here doing his Heaven's Aces routine, which is a fantastic.
Just to prove that all his magic isn't commercial. He's got something on there, just for magic for magicians.
You'll never, ever learn it.
You'll watch it and you'll go, ooh.
I've been trying to learn this. And
ooh,
I'm like,
that's good.
It's amazing.
Ooh, that's nice. I'll practice that in front of a mirror for hours for no reason. Ooh, it's great.
But there's some great stuff on here. So people are going to get this for free if they order Inception.
That's right.
So buy this.
12 midnight.
That's it, on Friday.
12 midnight on Friday. Get Inception. And we'll send you the Vegas Road Trip with Dave and Craig. Absolutely, completely free of charge. Chris, my hat's off to you. Awesome DVD.
Great stuff. So now it's one of the most anticipated products of this year. Paul Harris presents Matt Mellow's Wings. Synopsisizes, Craig.
It's an add-on to Twilight Angels.
So which is a great effect.
Twilight Angels is fantastic. The Twilight Angels, if you haven't seen us review it, basically what happens is on a rider back pack of cards or a mandolin pack of cards, the angel disappears from one end and appears at the other end together. That's Twilight Angels. What this is a way to make it look like you're apparently animating the wings on one of the angels. So what happens is they pick a card, they sign a card, you hold the card, and it looks like the wings are flapping, basically. And then what happens is they hold the card, and the angel moves from one end of the card to the other, a la Twilight Angels, and then you give them the card to keep. So basically all this does is this adds an extra bit onto Twilight Angels.
Extra little bit of business. And when Matt does it, he kind of says, blow the angel a kiss. You know, it's coming to life.
I'll blow a kiss.
And then you see it start to flap its wings like that. And, yeah.
Look, can I say something? You know, judging criteria said that at a certain percentage, we've got to go for a rant, so I'm sorry. Right, this is one of the worst products I've seen released this year. I'm disappointed with Matt Mello. Matt Mello, I went to bat for you. I went up to David Burglass and I stuck up for your any card at any number and I said it was the best. And I got ridiculed by him because I stuck up. And I still tell everybody that I go to, I say that Modern Mentalism, two DVD sets, it's one of the best DVD sets on impromptu card magic mentalism I've ever seen. I really do believe that. I've gone to bat for you. And what do you do to say thank you? You bring out this pile of trash. This is absolutely terrible. If you watch the performances on the DVD, the only time that people react is when they actually get the Twilight Angels revelation.
Are you sure because they're not reacting to the actual flapping of the wings?
They're only right. The first performance, the wings flap and they go, and then you see the woman visibly go, She figures out what's going on. Everyone sees what's going on.
Are you sure about that? You're not sure?
I'm 100% positive. The whole point is, watch his performance. You have to have the card as far back from the audience as possible. There's a reason Dave didn't get it off the sticks, and the reason is, it looks awful. So you have to go this far back, and it's a little wing about this big that's flapping. So they go, is that a slight movement?
Possibly. Everybody.
And if they go slightly further forward, they'll go, oh, right, I see how it works. The only way this routine is saved is because it's got the revelation at the end of Twilight Angels. My advice would be to take to wings, put it away in your bottom drawer where it belongs. Get your Twilight Angel cards out and just do that instead, because this adds nothing and is just complete and utter pants. That's what I think.
I must admit, I've shown a few people and it's not going to fool anybody. I couldn't really get it off the sticks. We wanted to kind of maybe see if it would work. And we just couldn't find anybody that couldn't see how it was done straight away. And whether it suffers because people in the UK don't recognise the back design.
No, I think that it suffers because it's rubbish. And I just think, you know what? I don't get it, because Paul Harris brings out so many wonderful products. And he is so much about the astonishment of the spectator.
Yeah.
And it's all about the astonishment. The spectators aren't going to be astonished with this. They're going to look at it and they're going to go, is something happening? Really? And then before they have chance to either A, realise that something's happening, or B, figure it out because it's blatantly obvious, you're going into the second phase, which is Twilight Angels. And that is great. And Twilight Angels is where you get your great reactions.
Is a great trick.
I do Twilight Angels. It's fantastic. It does not need this as a bonus to make it better. It is already good enough. This, if anything, ruins Twilight Angels because it gives people the ideas that the cards could possibly be gimmicked. It really isn't very good. You can't perform it unless you're really far back. It doesn't look very good. It's not very visual. And you know, it wouldn't fool a blind monkey. That's the bottom line. It wouldn't fool a blind monkey.
I'm trying to think of something to say in its defence, but I can't think of anything.
The artwork's quite nice on the front.
How much are you going to give it based on the criteria?
Me personally, probably 9%. I wouldn't touch it with a barge pole.
Right, I'm going to give it 18% because I wouldn't touch it with a barge pole, but probably Matthew would.
I would actually do it.
So the final review on this week's Wizard Product Review, we've got Flash by Chad Long.
Saviour of the universe.
And Chad Long, who likes to take it easy during his lectures.
Does he?
Yeah, and have a good lie down.
What?
You weren't there. It's okay.
No?
Don't you know about this?
What? No.
Nobody know?
What? Talk to me. Tell me. What
he got cramp at Blackpool, didn't he? And he had to lie down and
in the
stop
middle of
his lecture. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he did.
Oh, man. I hope you're better now, Chad.
Well, he was all right the next day.
Selling stuff on the stand.
Yeah, he was fine.
Standing right next to us. Shifting these flash like there was no tomorrow.
He was fine, but yeah, he likes to have a break during his lecture. And it's the jet lag.
Yeah, it must be.
But Flash, now, I know that you've been actually using this.
I've actually gone out and I've actually tried to work it. And you know what? I use your, which isn't really much of a creative leap to think. You know the knife routine that you do on the Hit the Road DVD?
Yes. Nice link there to one of our own products.
Exactly, yeah. Well, I actually use that and I love that. But I love this as well because this is even more organic. It's just shut up. This is, shut up.
Even
this
more is, organic
than knives. You know, you carry the knife.
I have got a nice line about these are my granddad's pen knives.
Yes, exactly, and that's what makes it workable. but these are flash drives. He's taken the colour changing pen knife and stuck it in a flash drive. And also, they look a little
bit
like
inside. Well, the pen knives are inside.
No, the flash drives. But they look a little bit like suppositories. So you've got that funny line to begin with, haven't you? You got like,
is that one of Chad's lines?
That's Mark Lavelle's.
Oh, okay.
Nicked it from him. But anyway, I'm going to do it. So, John, can you get it off the sticks for me, please? That would be awesome. So I've got two USB drives.
Should I move that? That's our judging criteria.
The judging criteria. I could turn a switch there while you're doing that.
It's very technical.
So I've done. I've got two flash drives here. USB
I like
sticks.
The passer so far.
Yeah, it's not bad, is it? Now, I have my flash drives, or I have my USB sticks, colour-coordinated. On the black one, I actually put all my music files and all my movie files, all
That's
my recreational
idea.
Files. Yeah,
that's a good idea.
On the red one, I put all my business files. So I put all the files for my website, www.slightlyunusual.co.uk. All the images for my
That's
Facebook
page. That's a good
page.
Line,
yeah,
isn't it, for
nice,
working?
Isn't it? Yeah. So I have these two flashcards. But I'm going to try something with them, and I want you to watch. I'm going to do this really slowly. We've got a red one and a black one.
Yep.
Hopefully you're not colour blind, because if you are, this trick's terrible. I'm going to put the black one here.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep the red one here. It's when I shake that they actually change places.
That's good.
It's good, isn't it? I'm going to do it again for you, but this time you know exactly what's going to happen, okay? I'm going to reach in and take out the black one. Now, I want you to watch. I'm going to put the black one in my pocket. If I put the black one in my pocket, what does that leave here?
The red one.
Until I snap. When I snap, now the black one's back.
Yeah.
I'll try and do it in slow motion. Look, I'm going to actually take the lid off the flash drive, okay? And I'm just going to take the lid, wave the body of the flash drive over, and when I do, the lid turns red, but the body stays black.
No, I'm confused.
So we've got a situation where the body is black, the lid is red. Of course, if I just do this, now you've got a situation where the lid is red and the body is black. Of course, I can actually take the lid off and I can squeeze the lid, and just by waving the body over, everything turns back to red. And if the red one's here, what do I have in my pocket?
The black one.
The black one, exactly. Now, the thing is, I actually have way more music files and way more movie files than I actually do work files, which is why I need more memory. Luckily, being a magician, getting more memory isn't very hard at all. And that's Flash.
It's very cool.
It's really cool. It really is. And it gives an ending to the colour-changing knives, colour-changing type situation. You've got that wonderful ending. When you do this, and I've worked this so I know this for a fact, people want to look at that. They don't want to look at the other one.
And this is not plastic, is it? Cheap plastic that's going to snap.
It's rubber.
So you're not going to sit on this and break it. It's solid. It's like solid rubber.
And the beautiful thing is, you just put it back in your pocket and I'm instantly reset, ready to go again.
I do like it. It
modernises the colour-changing knives.
I don't think they look like USB sticks.
You know what? They do. I agree. But I do agree that, but I think that in America, I reckon they probably do. I reckon Americans have USB sticks like that.
They look completely different in the UK, all USB sticks.
But I agree with that. I do agree with that. But when you...
So that's the only thing I would say is negative.
I do agree with that, but when you do this...
That bothers me. Do you know what? Looks a bit like a toy.
Oh, shut up. It looks nothing like a toy. When you do this, they see it's a USB stick.
It's a bit like a toy shop.
Oh, shut up.
You need a business card with a woman. You don't make it better, won't it, John?
Are you quite done?
A business card with a woman, and you talk about David and Dania changing dress colours. That'll make it all better. More organic.
When you do this, they know it's a USB stick. And there's so many different designs of USB sticks. This image here is universal. They accept that as a USB stick.
This
really
bit actually
do.
Works, and it's got the thing.
Yeah, exactly. It comes with a DVD with a whole bunch of different moves and ideas on it. So you can pick and choose. I'd pick and choose the bits that I wanted to put in there. You can as well. It's just a really commercial routine. You know what? I don't think you're going to do it.
I'm not going to do it.
But
I think it's okay.
I have started doing it, and I think I'm going to continue to do it and see what reactions I get from it. I'm going to give it 89%. I think that it's really, really good. I think a lot of people out there, if you're looking for a routine that instantly resets, no angle restrictions, really visual, nice routine with a great kicker finish. As I say, instantly resets. It's a working routine. I think this is the one for you. I really like it, 89%.
I'm not sure about this. I might be leaving myself open to some major criticism here, but if you could get the USB sticks that did actually store things, and then you used it in a trade show presentation and gave away the USB sticks at the end, I think it would be fantastic. So I don't know if that design is... something that is out there that you can actually do. If it was, I'd think it was brilliant and I'd be looking for ways to use it. As it is, because of the look, I've got a slight problem with it and don't think they look like what they look like, so I'm going to stick with that. But I'll still give it 79% because it's gone into Craig's number one set.
It's worth more than 79%.
No, it's, you know, it's...
That's really hard.
It's all right.
I'm sorry, Chad. I'm very sorry. I'd like to apologise on behalf of Dave.
It's all right. 79.
89%. Go buy it. If you're a working pro and you want a really solid routine, go buy it.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. You can follow us by clicking on subscribe right up there. You can go onto Facebook. We're Dave and Craig on Twitter as
well. Oh, yeah, check us out on Twitter. We've been tweeting.
That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. We'll see you next week, 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. And don't forget, visit us on the Facebook page and have a go and the Wizard Wheel.
Yes, please check out the Wizard Wheel and we'll...
It's got to that point in the day when I can't think of anything else to say. We'll see you
Dave.
Next week. I'm Dave.
I'm Craig.
See you next week.